Hey guys, it's 95 degrees out here. Don't tell me to put on a shirt, but well, actually you can tell me anything you want. We're here to update on the flex fuel issues I had, and I learned every problem and everything that happened, so I had to make a follow-up video to clarify all that. I want to get back here so it stays quiet. There's people outside and stuff. Now you got to go watch the first video to even understand this. So the whole issue was, in a nutshell, that the Cobb access port was not reading the number correctly. Right, I was at like a 35%. I knew because of my Fuelit Bluetooth dongle. And this is a middleman between a regular sensor and your regular harness. This is the middleman. That's what they do here. That was the issue. Two things had to happen. First off, who the hell was it? I think Cliff at EQT helped me out. He had to enable those sensor points in the tune, and he gave me the map back. That's the first thing I tried. Still didn't work. It gave me different numbers, some weird numbers. They were not correct, but it still didn't work, okay? So first off, I learned that if you don't have a flex map at all, you probably don't have those two wires, one or two sensors enabled, so they may not show up until you get the proper map. That's one thing to think about. Second thing was the Fuelit itself. The Fuelit, let's see, I bought this in 2018. Way back, oh my god, that was 5 years ago. I wasn't into any of this much level of detail and stuff like that. I bought the regular base unit, Bluetooth only, basic 0 to 5. They had a PWM output, modulation, I know it's pulse width modulation, but there was another word for it, a frequency signal. And this unit, as I configured it, doesn't have that. That was the problem. This is just a base unit. I didn't opt for the extra signals 5 years ago. I wasn't even thinking that I was going to do any of this. So, what I'm doing, I don't need to change the sensor. The sensor's a standalone piece. It's not different. The Cobb, the Fuelit, it's a Continental sensor. It's not even their brand. The issue is just the harness, and this going in between, changing the outputs, is what's breaking me. Why didn't you just, you know, unplug it and plug it back in? Unplug the pigtail and plug it in. Because it was too short is the reason. And that is, here, yeah, way too short. You have a nice clean install, and thusly, I could not even reach the sensor when I took out that dang Bluetooth 12-inch wire. So, I could have done that if it reached. I could have just plugged that in and be done. But instead, I have to use the proper full-length harness for my kit now. I'm just replacing it, that's all. Now, I'm losing Bluetooth from this. That was one of my favorite things. But then you gotta think, what's more important? Having your engine able to read ethanol, or having you able to check every once in a while? I can always go into Cobb, right, and check it, I suppose. I never have my Cobb. I don't wanna freaking have my Cobb. But I could if I need to check something. But I am losing the Bluetooth on this. From Fuelit, no fault of theirs, fair enough, I bought the wrong thing. They, I did chat with them about all this, and they said, yeah, you'd have to purchase a new unit, and you also have to get the special frequency add-ons and stuff like that programmed into your little pigtail module. So that is why. And I already had this kit. I said, I'm not gonna pay another $325 to get a new one of these stupid things. I'll just go with the kit I already have and lose Bluetooth. End of story. So let's see here. I did feel a click. Now I'm gonna do this cool little thing. Let's see, I'm gonna need two hands probably. I want to make sure I get this right. The problem is it sticks out a little far. I'd like a little UE here, but I'm not going to cut this up. That's stupid. I'll just make a careful bend, swing it around like that, and then feed it out here. I didn't even use this thing in the last one, but now I thought, hey, why not make it look pretty dang cool? It freaking works, guys. Freaking works. Eh, shut up. Hold on. Let me take care of this stupid light real quick. Shut up. Usually you get, there we go. That's all you do. Turn right, turn left, done. It's all clear. Look at this, it works. Holy crap, I did it. I mean, yeah, I lost my Bluetooth. I keep saying that. With this looking like this, I don't think it matters. It looks good. I don't know what the difference in these two are.
I mean, it's obviously the same monitor, right? Ethanol content read from sensor. Okay, whatever. Ethanol content used. Okay, I got it now. What's coming from the sensor and what the engine sees, kind of thing, to make sure it's not hugely offset, possibly. I got it. Sweet. Oh my God, dude. I'm ready for flex. I could, right now, just turn off the car and install the Cobb Flex Fuel Map. I don't think I'll do that tonight. I don't feel great, obviously, about putting any Cobb base map on. They're not great. So I'll probably just wait for EQT like everybody else. It would be pretty dumb to spend $1,300 on a whole IE new setup just to get Flex Fuel. And when I can, I mean, I hope it's not months, when I can wait for EQT. And for much less than $1,200, I'm assuming. I don't know, maybe it's another $200, $300 map, still better than $1,200. Maybe it's a $50 map upgrade. Who knows? Anyway, I got it, guys. Wow, huge. Oh, man, I'm going to sleep good tonight. Ethanol thing is working. Final nutshell, the one thing for you to remember, if you're using a Fuelit, make sure you opted for all the little fancy options when you bought it, or you might not have the right signal, and then you'll be screwed when you try and get the signal to read. Last human out.
Lane fast, call it high speed. I've been working hard, yeah, I've been working nightly. If you think you'll win, ha, not fucking likely. I be taking shots, yeah, cold-blooded.